The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program. We'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Well, hey, everybody. This is Tilio, and we, you know, I want to share with you the ego. And the challenges that people have. Adrian, you're going to keep looking backwards over there?
I was putting the Attilio's random thoughts.
You know what? I'm going to switch my topic. My topic is about focusing on one thing and being present with what you're doing, which is called the radio show.
Which we are doing.
So over here is the radio show. So mm-hmm. Why don't we, you know, the viewers can see in and stuff like that.
Okay.
But let's focus on our radio show, because I think that's the challenge that adults have nowadays, and even kids, is being present and focused. And the thing that, and I'll go back to my original topic, what causes us to get upset is the ego. And it's when we start making decisions or reacting in a certain situation or conversation with emotion versus logic. And granted, we are human beings with feelings and emotions, and you're going to get upset and this and that. But I think it's important to realize that when you're falling into that emotional state, how do I know? Here's the difference. And we'll just leave it at this and carry on with the show. But it comes down to one thing. I noticed that when people are in an emotional state, when they're dialoguing with you, they do a lot of telling. There's not too much curiosity. Because if you think about it, emotional, you're not curious or interested in what others have to say or what their input is or what their thoughts are. You just want to get into the telling mode, and that's the ego firing up your emotions and, you know, having you do, say, and maybe think things that are not while you're in the best version of yourself. And so we find, and by the way, this is all from psychologists and therapists, podcasts, you know, mindful podcasts, mindful books, mindful webinars. And what they all come to the conclusion of is that you've got to first is realize that you have that type of behavior where you're just reacting and then not asking a lot of questions. And then the second is, how do you switch from that emotional state into that state where you're like, you know what, let me just calm down for a minute. Let me take a minute. Let me pause and think about how is this person coming to, and what are they talking about, and what kind of questions should I have? Because Adrian, what happens when, and we talked about it in last week's show, when we think we know what the other person's talking about or what they're trying to communicate. What's that called? We talked about it on the last show.
The assumptions.
Yeah.
But we also talked about the assumptive close with being like making it like more of a positive statement, yeah, or almost like an affirmation.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So. But the assumptive part that I was talking about is just that's what creates the conflict when people are communicating with each other. So let's tie this all into real estate for us.
I wanted to make a comment about your emotional comments. I've got the bold laws here in front of me.
Oh, yeah.
One of those bold laws is logic makes you think, emotions make you act.
Yeah.
So.
And you got to think about it. Sometimes our actions are not things that we're proud of.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, having a thought in your mind and kind of taking a pause for a moment to go through things is something that very rarely do you get in trouble with, you know, unless they have the new thought police that I don't aware of that can actually read people's minds, and everybody would be in trouble if you could read all your thoughts. But the point being is you're less likely to be in trouble by thinking about something and pausing for a moment and asking more questions and gaining more information. And you're more likely to get in trouble by just like telling and pointing and sharing your opinion without receiving some dialogue versus a monologue? What's the difference between a dialogue and a monologue?
So ask more questions is what you're saying.
Is it?
Yes.
You see how I asked the question?
Yes.
I answered your question by saying, is it?
You answered a question with a question.
And then
is that what you're trying to get around to? Is asking with questions and not really answering the questions?
Well, asking a question to ask a question mm-hmm. that's productive in a conversation is because both parties are wanting to learn and have a dialogue. Answering a question with a question is because you're not really entering into a dialogue with someone. You're just avoiding answering a question. So there's a difference.
So don't play the question game is what you're saying.
Well, ask questions to truly learn, not ask questions to obfuscate.
Okay. Yeah. I needed clarity on that.
Yeah.
Because you want to know why? Clarity is power.
And where are you getting these things from?
These are bold laws, and it's actually a training that is offered through Keller Williams International. Uh-huh. And we've had them online during COVID times, and during non-COVID times, it's usually an 8-week training course that we all partake in. And it's excellent for mindset and, you know, just honing our skills as realtors and salespeople.
Well, I want to talk about a open house we're having tomorrow. It's going to be in Mariners Ridge. Mm. It's going to be from 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. on Sunday. So that's tomorrow. And we did have a brokers open earlier this week, and we had something like 28 brokers. A lot of them came with their clients. A lot of them came to do FaceTime or to videotape to share later. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that... Adrian, what do we have on all of our listings that would be helpful for buyers and or these buyer agents instead of doing the FaceTime and they still can come do that.
Oh, yeah.
Well, what's helpful?
So we do FaceTime in advance for them. So we do a full-on walking YouTube tour along with the drone footage so you can really see where the house is situated within the neighborhood, the kind of views that the home has. So it's a full-on walking tour of the home. We also do this Matterport tour, which is a 3D kind of click-through. So you could click through and really just get an understanding of how the home is laid out and the sizes of the room. So it's very convenient and helpful for...
So if you... Yes. So agents on any of our listings... Mm-hmm. Look for the, this is only for the agents because the public's not going to see this, but if the agents, if you look on the bottom of, right below the picture, there's a symbol on there that looks like a piece of a chain link, like a link out of a chain. If you click on
there.
That,
yes.
That's going to have our 3-in-1, which is going to be the drone footage, the video walkthrough, still photographs, as well as a 3D tour that your client, and it's all unbranded, so mm-hmm. you don't have to worry about them getting a hold of us. You just send this link to them and help us make you look awesome.
That's right.
That's our new model for buyer's agents.
Speaking of awesome.
By the way, speaking of someone that makes us look awesome.
We've got Jody Tonga, the mortgage genius, on the line. Jody, are you there?
Hi there.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
So what you got for us this week, Jody?
I wanted to touch on... APR, and APR is annual percentage rate, and the reason, I wanted to explain the difference between annual percentage rate and interest rate. So, mm-hmm. as a lender, we are required to provide you with both the interest rate and the annual percentage rate, but I'd like to focus an emphasis on the interest rate, not the annual percentage rate. And that is because the interest rate is the rate in which your monthly payment is calculated off of. So the actual payment that you're going to be paying to the mortgage company. And the interest rate is also the rate in which your overall interest paid over the life of the loan is calculated off of.
Hmm.
So some people get really caught up with APR or annual percentage rate, but that's not even the rate in which you're paying back the money.
So usually what is the difference between the APR and the normal interest rate? Is there like a big range between the two or relatively close?
It generally is relatively close, but it really depends on if you're paying points or not. So, yeah, the APR is basically the overall closing cost, which if you're purchasing, cannot be financed. So for me, you take the overall closing cost and then you add it back into the loan as if you were financing it, and then you re-amortize it over 30 years, and that's how you come up with the official calculation of an APR. So if your fees are super duper high, like the lender's charging you some sort of an origination fee or something like that, then that lender's APR is going to be higher than a lender who's, you know, charging you less of an origination fee. However, the reason I don't like focusing too much on an APR is because not all lenders illustrate their fees in the same way. So it could get confusing. And B, because you can't finance the closing costs anyway. So why would you need to see a figure that assumes you do finance them and then re-amortizes everything over 30 years?
I can see how that would be very confusing, especially with different lenders that maybe report differently on how their interest rates work.
Yeah.
So with Pacific Rim, how do you guys, how do you advertise your rates and programs?
So our general rule of thumb is that we do not advertise rates because
I was going to say, guys don't. That's how you advertise it. You don't.
Everyone has a different FICO score, a different overall debt-to-income ratio, different loan options. So we don't like to be reckless with our interest rates, and so we don't participate in anything that is some sort of a daily update.
Yeah.
And then also, our rule of thumb is that we provide an extremely comprehensive one-pager that is easy to follow and really covers all the key components. And one of my biggest pet peeves is when I am competing against another lender, which I have no problem competing, and I want you to find your best fit as a buyer. However, you're looking at something that only tells you how much you qualify for. So like, well, he said I qualify for 600. And I'm like, okay, so at that 600,000, what's your interest rate? What's your monthly payment? What are your closing costs? How much do you need to facilitate out of pocket? All, you know, there's a lot of other questions. And they're like, oh, I don't know. He just gave me this. I qualify for 600. And I'm like, ah. So for us, we really like to provide what I call a comprehensive illustration of all the key components with your qualifications. And sometimes I'm going to provide you with two or three of them because you may qualify for more than one loan option.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think, if I'm a consumer out there listening to this right now, here's my big takeaway. They should call and have a conversation with you because I think the challenge that consumers have and maybe a trap that they fall into is just reading the newspaper every weekend for the interest rates.
And it's confusing.
Yeah.
And you've got to do apples to apples kind of comparison where like you're out there shopping, but you may not have all the information. So it sounds like Jody and her team give a very thorough explanation of, you know, what those costs are going to be.
You know, Jody, did a broker's open earlier this week, and a couple of the brokers would come in and say, hey, are we required to get a pre-approval from Jody over at Pacific Rim for your listing? And I said, no, you're not. And he says, well, your remarks say that. And I say, no, it doesn't. Because the human mind wants to fill in what it wants to fill in based on its state of mind. And they're thinking that we're requiring this. First of all, Jody, you correct me if I'm wrong. If we put you're required to get a pre-approval from Jody from Pac Rim, isn't that a RESPA violation?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So, hello. We wouldn't be putting the word required.
Request.
In there.
Request.
It's, seller requests. And that's a big, big, you just request it, because it's not like, you know, we want Jody to do all the business. It's just we've done enough business with Jody that she improves the probability that this transaction is going to go through. Because Jody, are you finding it's just the lending requirements are stringent, they're changing, and it's highly competitive if you're trying to help somebody finance and get into an escrow, right?
Yep, it's so competitive.
Yeah, so you gotta everything. You gotta have everything going in your favor, and we highly recommend Jody and her team.
That's right, because she's the mortgage genius.
Yes.
Thank you, Jody.
Thanks, Jody.
Thank you. Bye.
All right, so you can get a hold of Jody and her team. Give them a call at 488-5510. You can also find them on teamlally.com under the resource tab on Experts We Trust.
Next, we got up is Bradley Maruyama with Allstate Insurance, and he's got his nugget or tip of the week.
Tip of the week.
What you got for us, Bradley?
Hey, how's it going?
Good.
Okay, so there's a lot of hurricane carriers out there.
Yes.
And recently, a lot of people, they want my opinion and what my house is covered, or which company covers my personal home. So we at Allstate, we have Palomar Insurance, ICAT Insurance, and Zephyr Insurance. So there's choices out there, along with other companies like State Farm and First Insurance. So what I've been telling clients is I personally try to stick to the hurricane carriers that carry an AM Best rating, A financial standing. The reason why I tend to want to, the reason why I tend to pick these financial stable companies is that if there is ever a catastrophe, we want to make sure that the house can be rebuilt, and we want to make sure that our house that gets rebuilt first. When you start to fall into carriers that don't have a strong financial backing, and let's just say there's multiple storms during Iniki, these were the carriers that were taking longer to fix these homes, or these homes are being fixed not even 6 months later, but up to a year later. So we want to stick to carriers that have stronger financial ratings. But what I want to let everyone know, my main tip with this is you got to look at your deductible. I've been noticing that I've been going up with other insurance carriers, and we're going up against not apples to apples. We're going up against carriers showing 3% and 5% deductible.
Wow.
But what does this mean to an insurer? Well, what it means is if you have a $500,000 structure, and a hurricane comes through and you're carrying a 5% deductible, that means the insured or the homeowner is going to be responsible for the first $25,000 in coverage out of pocket.
Yeah.
So if a Category 1 storm comes through and your roof is damaged and it's going to cost you $17,000 to fix that roof, you're going to be basically not going to insurance and paying for this roof out of pocket. So it's very important not to just go for the cheapest price, but to actually sit down with your insurance carrier and find out what are you actually being covered for, because we're losing some business and everyone's going to have their own fit, like Jody says, even with loans.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very important to understand what kind of coverage you're getting, because when that storm comes through and, you know, when you're closing, you wanted the cheapest possible premium. Yet to find out that when the storm comes through, you're $25,000 out of pocket. They're going to be like, oh, I wish I spent that extra 10 minutes to actually see what I was going, what I was buying at the time.
So Bradley, in generally speaking, the difference between maybe like a $1,000 deductible versus a $25,000 deductible, what kind of monthly dollar does that usually equal out to?
So it's going to depend on the structure of your home, if it's single wall versus double wall, or if it was newly built versus, you know, in the 60s.
Mm-hmm.
But typically, to go from a 1% deductible to a 3% deductible, you're looking at about $100 per year.
Okay.
But when you're looking at the bottom line price, if someone is $100 cheaper,
mm-hmm.
You're going to probably go with that cheaper premium, not knowing that the difference between the two quotes is a 1 and a 3.
The deductible.
They're automatically going to jump to that. Yeah, correct.
So pay attention to the deductible, people. You got to pay attention to that deductible.
Yes, that's a very important thing.
Sometimes we're going we're going head to head, and I'm like, geez, how did I lose this client? We gave them a really good premium. But why didn't they go with us? So when we go out and follow up, they're like, oh, you know, so-and-so was $79 cheaper. But I'm like, we have the same hurricane carrier. And then when I actually see it, to review it with them, it's because they had a 3% versus the 1%.
And perhaps that was not thoroughly explained. So,
yeah.
Pay attention.
And you know what's also good?
Yep.
What's also good to know, what we've been doing is we try to give options, you know, to our insurance that, okay, so but what we've been finding is from Honolulu to Mililani, ICAT hurricane insurance is very, very, very cheap. But that same carrier out in East Honolulu and Hawaii Kai, Neal Valley and Aina, they're the most expensive because they have different types of ratings. So it's always good to see options and see if the carriers could give you more than just one carrier to look at, because ICAT is also a Demotech rated company, meaning it's not the same financial rating system as the AM Best. But somebody may be shopping for price, that might be a better route to go if you're on a legally funded diet.
Yeah, Bradley,
Some people find it more important to get an AM Best rated company because they know AM Best ratings usually have better financial stability. So it's always good to find out, number one, what are you really covered for? Number two, does a financial rating really mean something to you?
You know, here's what I would tell people. You know, I'm hearing all of this, and I'm going to say that I'm in the happy middle. I'm in the bell curve of things. I'm in the fat middle, not on one end of the spectrum or the other. You know, I don't have like some massive high IQ, and I would hope that I'm not a knucklehead, but that I'm in the middle part, right? Knuckleheads on one end and somebody with a high IQ.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would agree.
You know, part of the Mensa Society, whatever, on National Honor Society. I'm not in that group. Mm-mm. But I would say that hearing all this information, here's what you got to do. It's called the triangle of trust. There's Adrian and myself in our business, and there's you, the client, and then there's Bradley. So the triangle of trust would be that if we trust Bradley and we're on a radio show for 10 years,
yes,
and we refer Bradley to all of our clients,
plus,
and
we use Bradley on our business and personal stuff.
My car insurance, my house insurance is always
our business insurance.
Business insurance is all with Bradley.
And we've had the moment of truth with him a couple times.
Yeah.
So.
And Bradley even told me, because we're such good clients, that you know how the hurricanes is the name of the hurricane is they go in alphabetical order.
Uh-huh.
Bradley promised to me when we circle back around to A that it's going to be Hurricane Attilio.
Oh.
He promised me because we're such good clients. Can I put that request in right now? I want it to be Hurricane Attilio.
I don't know if Bradley has control over that.
Anyway, so you don't have a regret. And you have Hurricane Bradley on your side. You know, maybe you should give him a call and have him review your insurance. The best time to start repairing the roof is when it's shiny outside. And the best time to be checking on your hurricane insurance is when there's no hurricanes more than less than 500. What is it? 500 miles off the Big Island?
Yep.
You got everything pauses.
Yeah, 500 nautical miles is typically when they start putting out those hurricane warnings.
Yeah. So before Hurricane Attilio gets within 100 miles of the Big Island, you might want to give Bradley a call to review that insurance and hopefully save you some money and make you a smarter insurer.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Okay. Thank you, Bradley.
Thanks, Bradley.
All right. So you can get a hold of Bradley and his team at 591-8016. And you can also find him on our website, teamlally.com, under the resource tab and experts we trust.
Now, I know we were talking about something at the beginning of the show, and then we segued into Jody and Bradley.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to continue that conversation, but I've completely forgot what I was talking about in the beginning of the show. So I'm going to move on to another topic. And that topic, we are a real estate show.
Yes, we are.
You know, every month, the Honolulu Border Realtors, they're super awesome, taking care of their members. They send out this little pictograph with what's going on with the real estate statistics, you know, taking something that's like super boring and turning it into a visual that can be easily understood. So I'll describe to you what we're looking at. It's just one page. And on one side, you have the median price for single family homes. And on one side, you have it for condominiums. Something interesting. So I started keeping these May 2020. Fast forward to today, July 2021. That's over a year, right? Mm-hmm. Year and 2 months?
Yep.
So interesting. The single family home price, Adrian, I know you can see it. What was it in May of 2020? Can you see it?
$797 is the median sale price for single family home.
$797,000. So half the home sold for that above and half sold below. And by the way, I remember what I was talking about at the beginning of the show. So I'll go back to that too. But
maybe after the break.
It's $992,500 today. Wow. Again, for July, that is a new record, which means in the same month last year, we're higher than the same month a year ago. New
That's
record.
Like a $200,000 swing on the median sale price.
So that median sale price has never been that high before, ever. $992,000. So bottom line, single family homes are going up. Last thing I want to leave you guys with before we go on our break, and Adrian tells you what's happening after the break, is we have a Mariner's Ridge home with awesome views open tomorrow from 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. When you go to that road, just look at all the signs and like breadcrumbs luring Hansel and Gretel to the witch's home so she can eat the little kids. Our little signs will be like breadcrumbs leading you to our open house, but we promise not to eat you. Just show you the home.
It's a beautiful home.
Yeah.
So we are about to take a break, but stay with us. When we come back, we'll be talking with Captain Joe Bardouche of Microseal Hawaii. We'll talk about how to permanently protect your furniture, cars, and carpets from stain and sun damage.
Come, my lady. Come, my lady. You're my butterfly.
This is Scotty B from News Radio 830 KHVH. Well, you've gone back and forth on it. You finally made that decision to sell your home or investment property. What do you do next? Well, you contact Team Lally. That's my recommendation. Here's an example of what they've done for folks just like you. Chris and Deanna Howell were at the end of a multi-year work project, needed to sell their Waianae home to move back to the mainland. Well, Team Lally engaged their incredible home selling strategy, which includes 3D interactive video tours along with a great media presence, and the property sold in just one day for $40,000 over list. Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. Their home selling strategy and marketing concepts are so successful, they're selling homes for up to $70,000 over asking. And what happens if you need to get out of the contract? Well, they'll let you out at any time, so there's no pressure there. Give Team Lally a call today at 799-9596. Online, it's teamlally.com, or even easier, just Google Team Lally. That's Team Lally.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you.
In Hawaii, I would hire Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. Their marketing strategy is so effective that if your home doesn't sell on terms you agree to, Team Lally will buy it.
Partner with the team I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Hey, Buck, as a real estate investor, if you were going to buy or sell property in Hawaii, what's the first thing you'd do?
That's an easy call. Call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. They've always guaranteed to sell your home or they will buy it. I love that confidence and the marketing that backs it up.
You aren't alone. Sean Hannity, Colin Cowherd, Scotty B., and Barbara Corcoran from Shark Tank all agree with us. Team Lally are the agents we trust, and that trust is well-founded. They're selling homes for up to $70,000. Over asking, what would you do with an extra $70,000?
How much time do you have? I mean, I've got a long list. Do yourself a favor. Check out all the reviews and see why thousands trust Team Lally. Google Team Lally, or if you want immediate answers, give them a call at 799-9596.
And don't forget to check out the Team Lally Real Estate Show right here every Saturday morning at 10. Get the best advice from Team Lally.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues. Give it to me, I'm worth it.
Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program. We'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com. microsealhawaii.com.
Well, hey, everybody. Our guest today is a managing partner at Microseal Hawaii and currently lives in Honolulu. He has also been a yacht broker at Harbor Yacht Sales since 2010.
Microsea Hawaii provides permanent protection for all fabrics from stains and sun damage. They apply their products to furniture, automobiles, carpet, rugs, and more with no effect on the look or feel of the fabric. Please welcome our special guest today, Captain Joe Bardouche.
And you know what, Captain Joe, say your last name for us.
Yeah, Bardouche.
Oh, Bardouche. Yes, I got it right.
I was thinking like Father Sarducci, like, you know, from the SNL, but that would be completely wrong because that was Italian and yours sounds more like French.
Yeah, actually, most people think it's Italian, but it's actually Belgian.
Belgian, oh. Yes.
Yeah, my grandfather was from Belgium. Yeah.
Gotcha. So. Okay.
Great grandson, yeah. Well, thank you for having me.
Yeah.
Of course. We've known Captain Joe for many, many years.
Yeah.
From his
sailing.
The sailing and captaining career. And just we're excited to have you on to talk about the Microseal part of your business.
So what is that Microseal?
Yeah. Well, Microseal is the reason why I get to go sailing. It's such a great business. So basically it's a franchise. I bought it back in 2005.
Mm-hmm.
It's an American company. It's an American made product. And the reason I bought it is because, I was given some of the product to try, and I tested it on some of my outdoor material as well as, you know, my kids' clothes, my wife's clothes, you know, carpet, mm-hmm. and, around my pets, and it worked. It did what it said it would do. And I thought, you know, I can get behind that. And so I bought that, the franchise for the state of, for the island of Oahu, and throughout the years, we've just grown and expanded to the outer islands as well.
Gotcha.
So Captain Joe, who would you say is the ideal clientele that should be applying this Microseal? Is it for anybody, or is there a particular type of furniture?
No, you know, really, it's for anyone. I mean, if you have something that you care about and you really want to take care of it, and whether it's you know you buy a new sofa or you buy a new rug, you buy a new car.
Mm-hmm.
We do a lot of auto interiors and it's just a great way to keep things looking newer longer. And in Hawaii, you know, not only are we much more active, our lifestyles here, but, and year round, but the sun really, really takes its toll on a lot of fabrics, yeah. even if they're not directly exposed, just the ambient light really, really makes a, you know, has a big impact.
You know,
so Microseal will really help with the fading as well.
Yeah. Can you Microseal the bottom of my boogie board so I can slide down the wave at a higher rate?
You know, unfortunately, it will not stick to plastic, vinyl, glass, wood, ceramic, kids, dogs. I mean, it only works on a fiber. And the reason is the reason why it's such a different product, and rather than making a layer on the surface of the fiber and just kind of sticking to it like other applicants do, like other uh-huh. protectants do, this actually is absorbed by the fiber. And then it cures there and it changes the fiber so that the fiber itself is no longer absorbent.
Mm-hmm.
And once it's there, it's permanent. You know, you can wash it, steam clean it, dry clean it. That does not affect the protection.
Gotcha.
So once it's on, like, that's it. It's protected forever.
Well, it's protected for, you know, the life of the fabric. And, I mean, fabric is still going to break down. I mean, there's,
yeah.
you know. Now, I will tell you that I have, you know, wool, you know, things like that. I have treated, hand-knotted wool rugs, and I do a lot of those. And I treated some that were over 100 years old.
Oh,
you know,
wow.
So, I mean, there are some fabrics that will, you know, some products that will last a really long time.
Tell us about your any repeat customers. We don't necessarily need to know who they are or what or the business,
like,
but
maybe
like
some
what is
like
this?
Unique pieces that
yeah.
you've been able to do the Microseal on.
Probably the most unique thing, the most interesting thing that I've done was a kimono.
Mm-hmm.
It was a silk kimono, and my client had this hanging, and she was noticing that it was starting to yellow a little bit. And this was a very, very old. I would hate to say how old, you know, it was an antique kimono.
Yeah.
And the silk was just starting to change a little bit. And not only did, the Microseal, it wouldn't, you know, recover that yellowing, but it will definitely stop it.
Yes.
I've done a handful of wedding dresses where, you know, people, they take their wedding dress and they want to preserve them. And even though they package them, they have a tendency to yellow as well.
Mm-hmm.
But, and the Microseal will definitely stop that from happening.
Gotcha.
I've done everything. We've done airplanes. We've done yacht interiors. You know, I'm in the yachting business. But we've done, you know, a lot of unique automobiles, you know, some high-end automobiles as well. But, even an automobile is a big investment for most people. Other than buying a home, it's one of the bigger investments that, you know, that they do actually make. And it's something if you do put that kind of money into, you definitely want to be able to protect it as best you can.
Now, I'm wondering, Captain Joe, if maybe some of the museums, they should be using your product to preserve their, you know, like their fabric items.
Yes, absolutely. And we've done some work for Queen Emma's Summer Palace.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we didn't do everything there, but we did some of the items. So we've done some, yeah, we've done some of the older items. That, absolutely.
Yeah, so are you finding, like, you know, is it places that have a lot of exposure and maybe a lot of use that this would be helpful? Like, I don't know, furniture inside, like, hotel lobbies?
So, like, Moana Surfrider, we've treated everything in their lobby. The Espacio Hotel, we treated every single piece of fabric in that entire hotel.
Wow.
It's only nine floors. But, you know, it's an absolutely beautiful property. We do work for, you know, Four Seasons over on Maui, you know, all the rugs that they have. There's a couple of hotels over on Maui that we've been working for, Hotel Wailea. So, yeah, a lot of high traffic areas, you know, they definitely want to protect those, especially the common area furniture.
Yeah.
You know, one spill and the thing looks terrible, and that could happen the second day, you know, they bought it, you know, so... You know, oh, yeah. So this definitely helps.
So if our listeners want to find out more about the process, your product, how to book a consultation, do they just go to your website, microsealhawaii.com? Or what's the best way for them to find out more?
Well, microsealhawaii.com definitely has, you know, a lot of information there about us locally.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's also, we also have, you know, our parent company, microsealinternational.com. Mm-hmm. And on that site, you would find everything from cleaning tips to the history of the company, the product, and how it was developed. You would find, you know, independent laboratory results, you know, a lot of testimonials
mm-hmm.
of the product itself. So the product's been pretty heavily tested. It's been tested, you know, independently and by the EPA. It is, it's given a GROS rating, which is generally regarded as safe. So I've never, in all the years that I've been doing this, I've never had somebody call me and say, oh, you know, it made me itch, or my dog, you know, doesn't like it. Or I've uh-huh. never had anyone once say they've been able to even detect it once it cures, because it's absolutely imperceivable.
Yeah.
So, there are no fluorocarbons.
So, Captain Joe, have you been able to do some work for Chef Chai with this Microseal? I know you guys are old buddies from way back. Has he used you in his restaurants yet?
I haven't, but I would love to. You know, I love Chai. He's a fantastic chef, and he's just a great human being.
Yeah. And, you know, he is a big fan of our radio show. Yes. He listens every Saturday.
Chef
so
Chai.
Chef Chai.
Oh.
Yeah, give Captain Joe.
So good thing I didn't say anything bad about it.
Who would say
anything bad about that guy? I mean, oh, my goodness.
Yeah,
he's the best.
He's the best because we were at his restaurant. Chef Chai, we were watching you. And we saw him bussing tables.
Yeah.
I mean, he's the big kahuna, but...
He knows what's happening in his restaurants.
You know a good owner, when they're never afraid to roll up their sleeves and get to work.
Mm-hmm.
So you know I managed his restaurant for a period of time.
That's why I asked about it.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, it was a fantastic experience. It really was. You know, I mean, Chai's a, you know, he's a very, very prudent business operator. That's why he's still in business, and he has been as successful as he has. Yeah. You know, he just makes a fantastic product, but he's not afraid to roll his sleeves up, and whatever needs to get done, gets done.
Yeah. And
Much like you.
Yeah, much like you, Captain Joe. We've seen
great minds think alike.
Do whatever it takes to get stuff done. And so,
well, he was definitely a great example for me. That's for sure. Yeah.
And I have a question for those people. You know, a lot of people just they want to be entrepreneurs and like yourself. What was the thing that said, "Hey, I want to do this versus the day job"?
Well, you know, I did the day job. I did the that for quite a bit, and and in all honesty, I have to give a little bit of credit to Robert Kiyosaki of all people.
Yes.
You know, I drove his boat for several years as well, and we used to have many talks. And you know, one of our talks was he used to tell me, "I need to stop trading my time for money."
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can't train our kids to just simply be a cog in the wheel. You know, not all kids were meant to work a regular day job. Yeah. And I think I was one of those kids. You know, and the idea of being able to, get a result out of my effort directly, I think is one of the things I like about being an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
You know, it's one of those that the more you put in, the more you get out.
Yeah.
You know, and the lessons are fantastic. The life lessons are incredible.
That's so cool that you got to captain
Kiyosaki's
boats.
When you said credit David Kiyosaki, I thought you meant like you read his book. I didn't know he was hanging
out
with him.
Nope. Firsthand, right out of his mouth.
I like to credit Elvis Presley back in 78 when we was had lunch together. He taught me how to sing. So that's pretty cool that you got to hang out with him. And, he's obviously been a national bestseller.
Very smart
keynote
guy.
Keynote speaker.
Yeah.
A great education program.
You know, ironically, I've never actually read any of his books.
You got the...
And they were always on the boat, and I just, I really never even thumbed through him, but him and I have had some fantastic conversations, and his wife, Kim, it's her boat, but, she loves the boat. She loves the sail. And, I'll tell you what, two extremely bright people. Yeah.
Well, we have access to David Kiyosaki through the books. You have access through him directly through your interactions and conversations. So, awesome. You didn't need to read the book because you got to talk to the author. So that was pretty cool.
He would tell me directly what I was doing wrong.
Yeah. That's it.
And then here you are today with Microseal Hawaii. This is a very unique franchise. You have, there's no other product that's like it.
Yeah.
You know, it's easy to run a business when you don't have a competitor.
Yeah.
But, in a town like Honolulu, we're a small town. You have a barbecue in your backyard. All your neighbors know it. We're so close. So to me, what's even more important than having a good product is having a service that backs it up.
Yeah.
You know, if my clients spill something and they can't clean it, I will show up at their house, and I do this all the time.
Yeah.
You know, I will come and help them clean it, and if it takes whatever it takes, we get it done.
Sounds like the moment of truth, we have with Bradley, our insurance guy. Like, if something goes wrong or awry and we need the insurance, he's there, just like you, mm-hmm. right? If there's a spill or some kind of incident, you're there and helping the client to remove the stain.
Too, just the thought I was thinking about when you look with the automobile interiors. I mean, somebody doesn't have to have a Lamborghini for you to go do this because. Some of these new cars are expensive.
They are.
A Tesla is like $120,000.
They're just going up, these prices.
Not even that. I mean, you've got a young family, especially if they have kids, and they go buy, I don't care if it's a Subaru, I don't care what it is. I mean, mm-hmm. it's well worth protecting. And, especially if you've got animals or kids or.
Kids will trash a car.
Well, I was hoping you could microseal the kids and the pets, but we're just going to have to settle for the actual interior of the automobile.
Unfortunately, those are what I can't control.
Yeah. Anyway.
So it sounds like an amazing product, and you're helping people to save important family artifacts, rugs, and the interiors of their car. I mean, there's just so much that can be done with this product.
I've got a lot of Hawaiian quilts and things that I have one particular client and I sear about every other month, she'll have some little project that she's made. She's crocheted, or you know that you know she's you know made these tablecloths and things. And you know, as soon as she's finished with it, she calls me. she calls me up. And,
she knows.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
So
gotta protect it with the Microseal.
Handing it on to the family. Yeah. So,
and if that's the thing. If it's something you love, protect it.
Yeah. Any last things that we any questions we should ask that we haven't covered with you before we let you get on with it?
Yeah, not that I'm aware of. I mean, but you know, I will say that you know when I deal with my clients and my clients have to deal with me and the warranty and any other issues, I'm who they're dealing with. They don't have to call the mainland. They're not talking to somebody there because we're a local company. We take everything on a local level.
So speak.
And I can say that Captain Joe is very good with his communication.
Yeah.
He's effective with responding, so
and,
just give him a call.
And everybody loves the 808 number, so what's your phone number? What's a good number for you?
808-256-7168.
7168, so it's 256-7168. That's the 808, and then also they can go to
microsealhawaii.com. That's
right. And on that number, they can text me, and I have many clients that'll text me.
Yeah.
Here's a picture of what I want to take care of, and I'll ask for a price, and I'll be able to give them a price. You know, like they're an exact price. Yeah.
That's so easy. Easy.
Easy. He's like the easy button.
Easy button for sealing your stuff you want to preserve.
Yes.
Okay. Thanks, Captain Joe.
Yes. Thank you, Captain Joe.
It was great talking with you guys. I can't wait to get you out on the water again.
Yes, yeah, we will be seeing you soon.
Yeah.
Let's do that.
All right. Bye-bye.
Okay, aloha.
All right, so that was Captain Joe. His company is Microseal
Hawaii.
And his number is 256-7168, 256-7168. Or just go to the website to check it out, microsealhawaii.com. And he makes it so easy. You just take a picture of what you want to seal.
And he gives you the price.
And he'll give you a price. And he's the guy to come take care of it and get you all squared away.
And protect those heirlooms or anything that's important to you.
All right. So, again, you know, the open houses are far and few between with real estate. In fact, they're pretty busy. And we just want to make sure that you guys always have the latest and greatest with what's going on with our open houses. So just go to teamlallyopenhouses.com.
And the other thing is that we are under some new COVID rules. So we are following all the COVID protocols with limiting our indoor visitors.
Yeah.
The actual under 10, yes.
Yeah, so I was reading the proclamation or
the latest.
The bullet points from HBR. Thank you so much, HBR, Honolulu Board of Realtors, for supporting your members. And you know how they make us read it? When you log into MLS, there's like a page covering your MLS, your multiple listing system, and it either says, I've read it, or
read later.
Or read later. And I know you realtors out there, you keep going, read later, read later, read later. Now you got like 9 things you got to read later. Just read it now. It's only short. Anyway, I think it was something like groups of 5, but then it said for the open houses, no more than 10. Yes. And I think outdoor, no more than 25. Mm-hmm. So you can have 25 people standing outside your open house waiting.
In line.
But if there's like 26, number 26, sorry, you got to pretend you got bad breath. You got to go down the street and you got to go stand in your own group and before we let you in. But
we're following the safety protocols.
Yeah, just be cognizant out there. We're wearing our masks. We have hand sanitizer. If you want to wear gloves, even better. And please, 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 if you have little ones, you know, telling them not to touch something is the exact opposite. They do exactly the opposite. They touch everything. And that may make homeowners, especially in the occupied homes, uncomfortable.
Yeah.
So before we got to microseal your kids and their hands because they're touching everything, don't touch, right? Number one way to get a kid to touch everything, tell them don't touch it. So that's what's going on with open houses and the new protocols. You know, we're just always adapting realtors. And again, we talked about it at the beginning of the show, no matter what's going on, have we ever given anybody COVID with our virtual tours?
No, and I'm glad that you brought that up because we discussed at our team meeting this week how great of a job that the one and only Howard Nett has been doing on our virtual opens, because we do have a couple of homes where we're not doing the in-person open houses. So Howard has been doing those, and they broadcast every Sunday
on our social media, Facebook and YouTube.
Yep, and I think
LinkedIn
as well. So I told him, because he's doing such a great job that he should even do the ones that we are holding open in person.
Yeah.
Just in case people don't want to head out and, you know, have to wait in the line or deal with the COVID stuff.
So keep an eye out. Yeah. For a virtual open, if you get it all, if you all like a super germaphobe,
and you'll get to see Howard,
you're like, oh, you know, I don't want to come to the open house in a balloon suit, in a hazmat suit, you know, and look like a bubble boy. So I'm just going to watch Howard.
Just watch Howard, and you know what? Live streams. He might even do a little song because he's a musician, and with the new COVID restrictions, he's sadly not able to play as much as he'd like to.
Here's a Team Lally factoid. If you go to teamlally.com and scroll down, you'll see the Team Lally jingle. And if you click on it, it'll play. And that's Howard, original composition.
And he sung it.
And production. Mm-hmm. And he sung it. And you'll be hearing Howard on our Team Lally jingle.
Yes. And you'll be seeing him on our social media doing the virtual open house tours.
By the way, folks, we, you know, half of our transactions, and we're well over 100 coming into the end of the year, half of those are working with buyers. So we are getting buyers into escrow. If you're frustrated in that situation or concerned or you're scared,
just call us.
Don't worry. We'll hold your hand. It's not like a haunted house. Even if it is a haunted house, we're going to walk with you. Mm-hmm. We're going to let you know when all the boogeymans of the offers and open houses is going to jump out, and we'll calm you down and we will get you into escrow because we're doing it for our clients every single week.
That's right.
I guarantee it. That's the guy, I don't know, he was on some cooking show. He used to cook Cajun cooking. That's what he would say. I guarantee it. All right. Anything else? Here's what we're looking for. We're looking for this one person, and it's inside sales agent. And that is somebody that comes into an office environment.
They are a phone pro. They love being on the phone, connecting over the phone, and they're organized. And they are on it, and they're excited to be on the phone.
Yeah. And you have a potential of making the same kind of money, or very close to it, of what agents make with commissions and in a controlled environment. And we give you all the coaching and training. Mm-hmm. And what you got to do, if you think you're that person, maybe you know somebody, they're just in a different environment, and they want to come into our environment and all our culture and get involved with real estate as an inside sales agent. You're going to need to get a real estate license. It's so easy. All you got to do is go to jointeamlally.com, start the process there.
See if we'll be a good fit for each other.
Yeah, see if we'll be a good fit for each other. If not here, we always can make recommendations, and we always want to be helpful for your introduction into the real estate career. And by the way, if you ever want to check out one of our career nights, HawaiiCareerNight.com.
Well, thank you for listening, and thank you to our sponsors.
Jody Tonga and Derek Tonga, Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley Mariama of Allstate Insurance.
Kenji Vendetta of Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
John Speed of Kilauea Pest Control.
Hu Kim Han of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle Shimoda of Impact Wealth Solutions.
Robinson Villavia of Fine Line Paintworks.
James Santiago of Kaji Cleaning.
Nikki Nakamura with American Floor and Home.
And Jake Kisak of Skyta.
Roofing and Solar. If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlally.com.
We also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Yee-hoo.
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed-upon price in your time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Thanks and aloha!
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.